morning. Welcome to Seraph Hour. My name is Victoria Abidoye, as you know, prophetess. Let us pray. Father Almighty, we just want to thank you again. We thank you. All praises belongs unto you for your mercy over us every day in our life. You are there. You wake up us to this morning. We sleep safely and you wake us up safely. We thank you. All glory belongs unto you. We thank you as we are going forward this morning in your word and in prayer. We want you to speak to us yourself. We want you to pray for us because we cannot even go out without you praying for us, without you laying your hand on our head, without you open the gates of the new day for us. Father, we want you to direct us, direct our path, direct our mouth, direct whatever we are doing today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray, amen. I say good morning again. I know we have a good night. Why is that? Our Father is there for us. Even when we sleep, that we don't even know where we are. God knows we are. He is a merciful God. He is a mighty God. We praise him. We magnify his name. Thank you, Father. Today, we just want to talk about key to a true Christian. What do I mean by that? A key to a true Christian. A true Christian, we wake up in the morning like we wake up now and praise God and pray to God and even give God whatever he wants to do. Lay everything down for God. That God, take control of my day. That is a true Christian. A true Christian, we do the will of God. A true Christian, we let the Holy Spirit of God direct him. A true Christian, we know left and right. He will know between left and right. He know left, he know what that can do. I know what right hand can do. A true Christian must follow Christ. A true Christian must looking for a good thing, not a bad thing. A true Christian must always pray and always pray and pray alone. A true Christian must not find a downfall of his fellow men or fellow women. Or if we look at the 1 Corinthians chapter 2 from 12 to 16, we say, for the body is one and have many members, and all the members of that one body, being many, are one body. So also is Christ. Verse 13 says, for by one Spirit are we all baptized into one body, whether we be Jews or Gentiles, whether we be bond or free, and have been all made to drink into one Spirit. For the body is not one member, but many. Not one member, but many. If the foot shall say, because I am not the hand, and not of the body, is it therefore not of the one body? Verse 16 says, and if the ear shall say, because I am not the eye, I am not of the body, is it therefore not the body? See, we are the body of Christ. The body of Christ. Anyone without the Spirit of Christ is alien to the kingdom of God. Anyone. I want you to know that anyone without the Spirit of Christ is alien to the kingdom of God. Are you alien to the kingdom of God? That is why we must be with the Spirit of God. We must let the Spirit of God direct us. That is why you wake up this morning, the Spirit of God is directing you to come before the Lord and kneel down and pray and listen to his word. Because his word is going to lead you through the day. His word is going to direct you because he is living in his word. He himself is that word. He himself is that word. And he himself, that word, the Spirit is inside that word. So it will be correcting you, wherever you do wrong. It is the word of God. So we must be in the Word of God all the time, every second. And we must keep on praying. In other words, some people say, pray 3 times a day, pray 5 times a day. No, pray every second. How do you pray every second? You don't have to need the hour every second. No, in your mind. You can even say only one word. Keep on saying, Father, I thank you. Father, I thank you. Father, I thank you. Sometimes I say, Father, have mercy. Father, have mercy. Father, have. You see, it is a big prayer. It is a big prayer. You need to know that because God listens to you. Don't forget that that spirit is in you. It means that you are motivating that spirit. And God himself will be happy with you. Because all the time, you just keep on saying, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. He knows. He knows. He can read you. That spirit in you can read you and take direct to our Father. He is living in you, Father Almighty. So a true Christian must know how to pray. A true Christian must know the Word of God. A true Christian must know what our Father in heaven wants you to do. A true Christian. In Romans 8, verse 9, I said, see, anyone without the Spirit of Christ is alien to the kingdom of God. If you are not with the Spirit of God, you are alien to the kingdom of God. So we must be in spirit. That is why you and me wake up this morning. We want to tap that spirit. We want to tap that blessing. We want to tap that the protection. It means that when you wake up in the morning, thank God, as we usually do. Listen to that word. Pray. Whatever you want the day to bring for you, he will bring it for you. Because God knew you. He knew that you wanted, but he wants you to ask. So a true Christian, we ask from Father before he can do anything. That is a true Christian. A true Christian will love his fellow men and his fellow women. A true Christian must not lie to himself. A true Christian must do the will of God alone. In the book of Romans 12, let us see the book of Romans 12. As we all know, Romans 12, verses 1 to 2. Let's see, Romans 12, verse 1 to 2. It says, do not allow the flesh to make you disobey the Lord. Please don't allow flesh to make you disobey the Lord. See, God is warning everybody. We must not, allow any flesh. Flesh can make you disobey God. But we need to be careful. We really need to be careful. Let us put that down there. Romans 12, verses 1 and 2 say, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable, unto God, which is your reasonable service. Verse 2 said, and be not conformed to this world, but ye be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that ye may prove that what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. We must not mingle ourselves to the world, because we are not of the world. We are of our Father's house, heavenly, up there. We are not of this world. You see, if you put yourself to this world, then you are on the hand of Satan. But if you are with God Almighty, guess what? See, whatever you ask, it's going to give it unto you. That is why I say, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, everybody, that you are under this word this morning, under the canopy of Almighty God, to listen to his word. I beseech you this morning, please, I beseech you, by the mercies of God, that all of us must present our bodies as a living, holy, acceptable unto God. You see, wherever we are going, people of the world must know that we belong to God. Our behavior, whatever we do, if somebody asks us a question, our answer, people must know that, oh, these people and this person, this man or this lady, she is, a Christian, real Christian. Because everybody called himself Christian. Are you a true Christian? Am I a true Christian? You see, do we even believe this God that we are following? You see, or we are just calling him, just mere calling from our mouth. You see, that is why I beseech you to present your bodies a living sacrifice. A living sacrifice. Some people, we just go out, dress whatever you like, you know, dress like the angel of heaven. The angel of heaven, when God sent them to give us something, if God open your eyes, you see them that they are with the, you know, you can not even see their toe, their leg. You see, I don't say you should do that, but present yourself holy, that is acceptable before God Almighty. That even when you pray, people know, yes, you are a true Christian of God. See, and even your behavior, we show the people outside that you are true Christian of God. May the Lord be with us. Let us present ourselves, you know, and let God Almighty be happy on us. Now, let us see First Corinthians chapter 1, verse 18. 1 Corinthians 1, 18. Let us see what he's about to tell us. This morning, 1 Corinthians 1:18 says, "For the preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness, but unto us which are saved, it is the power of God." See, the power of God. Our preaching is the power of God. Even he said, "For the preaching of the cross is to them that perish." Those people want to perish. They are all foolish. You see, they don't care. They don't care. But for you that you care, you listen, you sit down, you wake up and listen to the word of God. You even come in the night, you listen to the word of God, and you pray. Even in the afternoon, you pray. They think you are foolish. No. No. But don't do that. Think about them. They are walking towards perish. But you, that you believe in God and you are a true Christian, you are safe with the power of the Almighty God. That power of the Almighty God is there for you. It's there for you to control your life. Is there. He said, God uses his words to empower the children of God. God Almighty, he uses his word, the word, this word, word, word. This word is fire. It is fire. This word was the word that God takes to create heaven and earth. He said, let there be light. And there was light. Let there be light. And there was light. Let all the water outside, and let the earth come up. And it was so. We can all see this thing in Genesis 1. We Christians, we all know what I'm talking about. You see? So, this 1 Corinthians 1:18 says, God uses his words to empower the children of God. His word empowered us. His word directed us. His word is broken the plan of the devil. His word is destroying the power of the devil. So his word is so powerful. His word is like, say, eternal life, eternal life. I want to be eternal life. Lord, save my soul. I want to be eternal life. Lord, save my soul. We all want to be eternal life. Eternal life. Let us work to inherit eternal life. We thank God this morning. We are going to pray this morning. I want you to pray with me this morning. See, I want you to pray. First of all, thank God. I thank you, God. This morning, it is a glorious morning that you give unto me. That you let me see this morning. You wake me up this morning. It is by your power. It is a gift of God. It is by your grace that you wake me up this morning. And I open my eyes, I can see, I can talk, I can move. Oh, Father, we thank you. Pray. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. For this morning, you are a good God. You are a merciful God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We praise your name. We magnify you. Thank you, Jesus. We sleep safely. We wake up safely. You are a merciful God. Father, accept our thanks. Father, accept our thanks. Father, accept. Pray. Thank God. Thank him that we appreciate you, Daddy. We appreciate you, Daddy. We thank you, Daddy. You are in our life. You are the controller of our life. We thank you, Jesus Christ. We thank you for this word. We thank you, Father Almighty. Well, when we wake up this morning, we meet your word. We ate your word. We ate it, and we know it's going to do good for us throughout the day. We thank you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We pray. Amen. Now let us ask God, Father, forgive us all our sins. We don't know. We have been, maybe we have moved with Mr. Satan before, Mr. Heaviness, Mr. Foolishness, Mr. All this that we learn on the Galatians. We say, Father, forgive us. Forgive us. I've envied some people. Please are provoking. Father, forgive me. Even when I don't know. Pray. When I don't know, that is even hindering my prayer as a Christian. I'm not supposed to do all these things. Father, I'm telling you all my sin this morning. Father, forgive me. Pray for forgiveness, because it's a merciful God. He's going to forgive us. Pray for forgiveness. The sins of our forefathers, the sins of our foremothers, that we are swimming in it. Father Almighty, because of your blood that is shedding on the Mount of Calvary, Father, take it to forgive me. Oh Lord, please, I plead your blood this morning. I plead your blood. Pray. Plead the blood of Jesus to cleanse you, to cleanse me from all my sin. I plead the blood of Jesus. I plead the blood of Jesus. Cleanse me, Father. Cleanse me, Father. Cleanse me, Father. Wash my sin away. Wash my sin away. Wash my sin away. Don't let me sin anymore. Let me inherit that kingdom. Because you say, if anybody sin, oh, Father, the end is death. We don't want to die. You say when people sin, the hand was sin pain. The sin pain, the death. We don't want to die now. Father Almighty, come and forgive. Come and forgive. Father, forgive us. Father, forgive us. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Now, let us pray. He said, anyone without the Spirit of Christ is alien to the kingdom of God. We don't want to be alien to the kingdom of God. Father, pray. Father, don't let me be an alien to the kingdom of God. Father, I want you to give me your spirit. That spirit of yours that you are giving into people, your people in those days. I want you to endow me your spirit. Your spirit that we know good to right to do this, but that is not right. Father Almighty, Father, come and give me, endow me your spirit. The spirit in those things that I'll be doing your work, that I will be a good Christian, that even you'll be happy with me. Because you're happy with the Abraham, our father. Pray. You happy with the David. Even if David sin against you, he asked for forgiveness. You forgive him, and you even give me grace, and David, you conquer all the war of his life. Father, I want that spirit that will be directing me, that I will be doing your will, and your will alone as a Christian, and people will know that I am yours and you are mine, that I am doing your will. Father, come and give me that spirit, your spirit from above. Father, come and give it unto me in the mighty name of Jesus. I don't want to be the alien to the kingdom of God. Father, I want to walk your word throughout my life, and I want to hear that voice that come into your Father's kingdom. Father, this is what I want. Father, do it for me. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Let us pray again. Father Almighty, do not allow the flesh to make me disobey the Lord. Father, pray. All the flesh, Father, don't allow flesh to make me disobey you. Father, don't allow flesh to make me disobey you. Don't let me disobey me, obey you. But Father, let me do your will. I don't want to disobey you. Don't let me disobey you. Father, I want to do your will. Your will and your will alone. I want to do that commandment. Your commandment that you have given unto you. I want to do your will and your will alone. Pray. Father Almighty, I want you to direct my life. Give me wisdom. Give me knowledge. Give me understanding to know that you are my God. To know where I am going. To know left or right. To know the way you are directing me. To be a good Christian. Father, to do your will. Father Almighty, come and give them to me in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray, amen. Now, he said, do not be a slave to sin. You pray, Father, don't let me be a slave to sin. Pray, Father, don't let me be a slave to sin. Father, don't let me be a slave to sin. Father, don't let me be a slave to sin. Father, don't let me be a slave to sin. Father, help me, oh Lord. Don't let me be a slave to sin. Father, don't let me be a slave to sin. Father, take the sin away from me. Father, take the sin away from me. Father, sanctify me for yourself, O Lord. Sanctify me for your work, O Lord. Don't let me be a slave to sin. Father, come and help me. Father, come and help me. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. He said you need the Holy Spirit to make your life relevant to God. Father, we pray. Father, I need that Holy Spirit to make my life relevant to you, O God. Father, endow me that Holy Spirit. Pray. Father, I need that Holy Spirit to make my life relevant to you, O Lord. Father, give me that Holy Spirit. Father, give me your Holy Spirit in the mighty name of Jesus. Give me your Holy Spirit in the mighty name of Jesus. Give me your Holy Spirit. Father, your Holy Spirit is the one that can direct me. Holy Spirit, you direct my day, you might direct my week, you direct my month, you will direct my year. Oh, Father Almighty, give me that Holy Spirit. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Let us pray. Father Almighty, we thank you very much for this word of exhortation this morning. We know that you have speaking to our mind, and I know you have given us that Holy Spirit that will be directing us, because we don't want to be a sin to a slave to a sin. Father Almighty, come and direct our path. We don't want to provoke anybody. We don't want to envy anybody. We don't want to lie. We don't want to thief. We don't want all those bad angels to control our life, but we want the good angels to control our life. Father Almighty, come and accept our thanks this morning. We thank you because you have answered our prayer. As we are going out today, this morning, we want to be our Alpha and Omega. Father, you be the Alpha and Omega of sun, because every morning he will rise up in his rising place, and he will be going. He won't even look back. Father, that power, that Holy Spirit that will be given to sun, that will rise up in the morning and we go directly. He is not going to even listen to anybody. Father, this type of Holy Spirit, come and give it unto us, Lord. As we are going to our working place this morning, come and be our Alpha and Omega. Whatever we lay our hand today, let it be fruitful. Father, this day, all the goodness that is in this day, Father, let it be our portion. In the mighty name of Jesus, let it be our portion. In the mighty name of Jesus, let it be our portion. As we are going, let us go safely. Let us come back safely. Those people who are looking for job, Father, come and provide for them. Those people who have already got job, Father, come and be with them, oh Lord. Come and let their job be okay for them, oh Lord. Those people who are looking for this or that, you know everybody, Father, come and open the gate of job in front of us, O Lord. As we are going, when we shall come back, let us come back and come and give glory unto your holy name. Father, we are praying for those people who are in the hospital. Come and be with them. Some people who are sick, come and heal them. Some people having a baby, let them be delivered safely. Some people because of this or that, Father, come and be with all your people, oh Lord. We pray for all your churches around. Come and pray for them, oh Lord. Father, come and bestow your spirit unto everybody, oh Lord. All the leaders, all the pastors, everybody, the prophets, come and pray for them, oh Lord. Come and direct us, oh Lord. We are heading to the kingdom of God. We don't want to lose the kingdom of God. Oh Father, don't let us lose the kingdom of God. Father, come and direct us with your spirit, oh Lord. Let your spirit keep on directing us. Let us do your will. As a Christian, we pray for the whole Christian dawn. Father, come and renew our power. Come and renew us. Come and renew our power. Come and renew us. All those people who are left Christian and go to the sin, bring them back to yourself, oh Lord. Father, come and help us. Come and help us. We pray for everybody that is looking and listening this morning, Father, as they are praying themselves. Father, let their prayer be as acceptable before you, Lord. Some people have obstacles. I know that obstacles, it doesn't belong to them anymore. It is your portion to do it for them. We want you to surmount all the obstacles before everybody this morning. Father, come and do so, oh Lord. We bring all our children unto you. Come and pray for our children, Lord. Come and be with them as they are in holiday. Come and be with them, oh Lord. Father, come and protect them. Wherever they are going, protect them, oh Lord. Wherever they are eating, protect them, oh Lord. Wherever they are wearing, wherever, Father, come and be with them. We thank you, Father. We thank you, Father. We thank you, Father. Take glory. Take glory. Take glory. Father, take glory. Son, take glory. Holy Spirit, take glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. We thank God this morning. You are listening to Seraph Hour. We thank you. As you are going today, I want you to talk to somebody. I want to, you know, tell somebody about Christ. What Christ can do. What Christ has been doing in your life. As a Christian, what he has been doing in your life. Tell somebody. Because there is a lot of people out there. They don't even know who is Christ, who is Jesus. In your working place, tell somebody. Only one person today. You see, bring one person to Christ. You see, it is a crown for you up there. Talk about Jesus. You see, whatever you say today, let it be from the Spirit of God. And whatever you are doing, it will be spiritual. So pray every second. Pray every second. Make somebody happy. May you be happy. I pray for you today that you will be happy. Whatever you lay your hand upon, it will be fruitful. If you have obstacle, that obstacle is not your portion anymore. It has gone. God has raised it totally. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Join me again on Seraph Hour, Monday through Friday, 5:30 on ABN 15.9. Thank you and good morning.